Good day, everyone. This is Chris, the Ancient Scholar. So today I'm going to talk about calculating a dopamine infusion. And this applies to many other infusions, but dopamine happens to be the reoccurring infusion when it comes to paramedics. And some people were really amazed by what I was doing in a pharmacology class I was teaching earlier on in the week, and they just people were telling me just how great of a mathematician I must be. And I told them, well, I'm actually not a particularly good mathematician. I just have some good tricks up my sleeve, and I'd like to go ahead and show you some of those tricks today. Okay, so when we talk about a dopamine infusion, that's always going to be in micrograms per kilogram per minute. Okay, so it's a weight-based infusion, micrograms. You only have to memorize one formula for these types of infusions, and that's this formula here. That's the dose times the weight in kilograms of the patient times 60, right? We're talking about giving 60 mils per hour, 60 minutes an hour, dividing by the concentration. So let's just go ahead and make something up. So let's say that I have a 60 kilogram patient. I want to give dopamine, let's do 10 mics per kilogram per minute. Okay, we know the dose of dopamine is anywhere from 2 to 20 mics per kilogram per minute, so that seems to be a reasonable dose depending on what's going on with the patient. And then let's just go ahead and mix. We have to mix our own dopamine. Let's say that we mix 200 milligrams in 100 milliliters. Okay, all right, so I have all the basic information I need to figure out what's going on. The first thing that I want to do is I want to go ahead and calculate my concentration. Okay, so I've mixed 200 milligrams of dopamine in 100 mils of, say, normal saline. No big issue there. Okay, well, because we are running our infusion in micrograms per kilogram per minute, I need to convert this milligrams into micrograms, right? Well, let's remember, 1 milligram equals 1,000 micrograms, right? So 10 milligrams would equal 10,000 micrograms, and 100 milligrams would equal 100,000 micrograms, right? Just basic conversions here, no calculator at this point at all. So 200 would be 200,000. Okay, so 200,000 micrograms in 100 milliliters. Everybody's okay so far? Let's go ahead and condense this down. I have some zeros. Why not just take out these zeros? Cancel them out. What does that give me left over? That's 2,000 micrograms per 1 milliliter, right? That's all I have left over is 2,000 micrograms per milliliter. So now I have my concentration. So I go up to this formula here. I take the dose. I'll write it over here. The dose is 10 mics per kilogram per minute. Multiplied by the patient's weight, 60 kilograms, multiplied by 60, divided by my concentration, which I got down here, is 2,000, right? Now, let's just go ahead and do my math. I don't need a calculator for this. I have a bunch of zeros, right? This is just basic algebraic properties. What's 6 times 6? That's 36, right? What's 1 times 36? Still 36. So I've got 36. I have a power of 10 here, a power of 10 here, a power of 10 here, so why not just add 3 zeros for each power of 10? 1, 2, 3. 36,000. I don't need a calculator for most of these calculations. 36,000, okay, divided by 2,000. Let's go ahead and knock out some zeros here. Okay, that's what I have left over. 36 over 2, okay. So then I can divide 2 into 36, right? So 2 goes into 3 one time. That gives me 16. 2 goes into 16 8 times. My dose is 18 milliliters per hour. So if I run my infusion at 18 milliliters per hour, that will give me a dose of 10 micrograms per kilogram per minute. I need only to hang 60 drop tubing, right? 60 drops per milliliter. And if I attach 60 drop tubing to this, then milliliters per hour will equal drops per minute. Okay. So if I'm in an unfortunate situation where I don't have an IV pump. I just hang 60-drop tubing, and milliliters per hour equals drops per minute, so I would run my infusion at 18 drops per minute. That would get me 18 milliliters per hour. A very easy math here. If I had some other type of tubing, then I'd simply do my IV rate, flow rate formula to figure that out. And you guys remember that, right? Rate times factor, let's say we're using 10-drop tubing, divided by the amount to be infused times the tubing factor divided by time in minutes, 60, right? So what's 18 times 10? Well, just add a zero, right? 180. Okay, 60 goes into 180 how many times? Three times. 3 drops per minute if I had 10 drop per milliliter tubing. So it's very easy to work through these calculations knowing just a couple of essential formulas. Of course, the major formula being this one here. Okay, guys, hopefully that made sense. And as always, thanks for hanging out.